Amen. It is good to know that God is always faithful, faithful to his children. I'm going to introduce the speaker. Most of us know Harley. I came to know this godly man a number of years ago when God had blessed him with a powerful radio ministry. As a matter of fact, we had three brothers visiting our lecture last night in the discipleship class from Calvary Chapel. I think Diamond Bar. And one of the brothers said that he became a Christian from listening to Nightlight. I still get calls here at the Vett where folk remember Harley and I on the radio, and I'm never amazed to find out how many people received salvation during those very important years of late night radio. The convicting word, when preached by a powerful voice who will not compromise. And see, and that's why Family of Faith is a sister church to Olivet. We will not compromise. I find it extraordinary how God can place two churches of same mind in opposite parts of this city and is doing the same thing. Multicultural, thoroughly biblical, strong leader. Harley Howard is more than a personal friend of mine. He is a true yokeman of the word. Because once Harley compromises, and I see it, I'll tell him. Once I compromise and he sees it, he'll tell me. He is a preacher that is not that concerned about who does not like to hear it. For he knows that God has given him the commission to speak the truth, and he speaks it in love and with boldness. He is one that is opinionated because his opinion comes from the book. And since it comes from the book, I'll listen to him. When the opinion comes from his mind, from his heart, from his yearning, from his toil, I cease to listen. But Harley presents the book, and he presents it in such a fashion that it causes all godly men and godly women to take note. Harley Howard is a friend of this church, and Family of Faith is also a friend of this church. Family of Faith, I understand, is going through the same pangs that we went through a few months ago to purchase a facility that you can own, that you can worship in, that you can grow in. And I'll be praying for you, and you continue to pray for us. This has not been easy. All this looks easy. This isn't easy. This is a faith move. And the moment we compromise this book, God will remove us from this place. Lenny, why don't you come up and render another selection, and then we'll have the speaker of the hour. My friend, senior pastor, teacher of the Family Faith Bible Church, Pastor Harley Howard. Thank you, Lenny.
Pilgrims on the journey of the narrow road, and those who've gone before us line the way, cheering on the faithful, encouraging the weary, their lives a stirring testament to God's unchanging grace. Surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us run the race not only for the prize, but as those who've gone before us, let us leave to those behind us a heritage of faithfulness passed on through godly light. Oh, may all who've gone behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we leave lead them to believe, and the lives we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. After all our hopes and dreams have come and gone, and our children sift through all we've left behind, may the clues that they discover and the memories they uncover become the light that leads them to the road we each must find. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that they lead them to believe, and the lies we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful. May the fire of our devotion light their way. May the footprints that we lead them to believe, and the lies we live inspire them to obey. Oh, may all who come behind us find us faithful.
Oh, may all who come behind us
find us faithful.
Amen. Pastor John was saying some interesting things about me, things I really didn't know. I was about ready to turn around and see if it was someone else behind me he was talking to. Let's pray. Father, it's wonderful that there are churches left. There are saints in this world who really have a love for you and who have a love for the truth. Although our numbers are getting much smaller, nevertheless, those who are faithful will endure all the way to glory. I just pray that you would teach us tonight, that we would all have hearts that yearn to want to know the truth. And may your Spirit fill us and speak to us in his own unique way tonight. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Pastor.